COCOBONGO. We are off tonight. We're on a night out, We're off to COCOBONGO.
Yeah, I don't know what it's about, is it? I think it's dancing and shows and all that kind of stuff.
It's about 40 Las Vegas shows apparently in one show.
There you go. And I'm 10 of them. And I get the shop off, fucked out.
Oh dear. And apparently Danny said Jim Carrey owns COCOBONGO.
It is in Cancun, so I think in the mask thing. That's where he's at, you know, he's in that nightclub, it's COCOBONGO that he's in.
Well, I'm fresh from my Bacata class, so I'm
going to be... But my mate Dan, Big Bear, he told me about it, and he said, that's it. But anyway, it's transport.
Let's go! Golf cart awaits. Oh, look at that. Just for timing. So we made it out of the van. Being cramped up with his legs in the air like we just don't care.
We're just getting blood back to my toes.
Yeah, but now we're COCOBONGO showtime. Let's go. The rules are no drugs, no smoking, and no puking up in the van. I can't promise them the puking up, everything else is easy.
Right guys, so as we headed to COCOBONGO, we had a quick look outside, Hard Rock Cafe, couple of restaurants, and we had a good look round, and it started to fill up pretty quick. And I'm thinking to myself, this night is going to be a night to remember. Now, me being me, I booked a standing tickets, and as I am getting ready to queue up, I noticed that there were upgrades available and that you could get yourself around a bit of a table. And I'm looking at Sophie and she's already starting to boogie. So I'm thinking, oh, this ain't going to be good. If I'm going to be packed out, I need to be sat down. But there I am. I'm in the queue. I've upgraded to seats. We're waiting to go in. The atmosphere is starting to get good. The staff are out. They're dancing. They're getting the crowd geared up. And I tell you, this was something that I was looking forward to doing. We made his way in. It started off with dancing. Michael Jackson there, look. They're all giving it. I'm thinking, this looks all right. All of a sudden, they're swinging from ceiling. They're jumping around like lunatics. And this stuff just carried on for a good half hour. Then, glitter ball starts. The big show is about to begin. And I'm thinking, what more can they offer? You know, there's a bit of a dance floor down there, but what more can they offer? And what did I not know? Lasers. Acrobats, it were all going on. It were getting absolutely insane. The crowd were there, they started having a few drinks. It were an all-inclusive venue. So as the night progressed, everybody started to get more and more into it, more and more enjoying themselves. Not just them, but me and Sophie as well. Then it kicks off. Mask, off they go. The shows that these guys put on, right, were just absolutely amazing. They were doing all different scenes from different movies, singing all different songs from all different stage shows. They were doing all different singers, and it was just absolutely class. And as you can see, as the night went on, the crowd just got rowdier and rowdier. It was absolutely nuts, all right? You've got to have been there to appreciate the music, and then bang, here it goes. It kicks off. Balloons, smoke, there's confetti everywhere. It just went absolutely crazy. By this time, everybody is having a whale of a time. Michael Jackson comes on. I mean, look at this guy. To be honest, I'm thinking, hey, he's still here. He's gone nowhere as this lad. Here he is, dancing away. But throughout the night, it just got better and better and better. There were all sorts going on. Batman, we've got scenes from Batman now. And it was like being in movie. Movies brought to life. It was absolutely fabulous. Everybody enjoying themselves. It was nuts. There was smoke. There were balloons. There were confetti. What a night to remember. I absolutely loved it.
Oh my days. What a night. We had a little issue at the end of the night. Couldn't find the van home. And then keys won't work in the door, but oh my days, we're dancing all night. I'm so proud of us. We stayed up till 2 a.m, which is like 7 a.m. UK time. I thought we'd be done, to be honest, at 10 p.m, but it was wicked. The show just continued and continued and continued and continued. And then they got a lot of audience participation, which I thought was very clever, getting the audience to be your filler dancers. But yeah, me and Dan, honestly, we had a wicked time. I am the luckiest girl in the world. Now I'm off to the gym. Dan's still getting up. And then it's yoga and brekkie time. COCOBONGO. Defo check it out.